if someone comes to her and she can just sense a little nervousness in their voice, a little anxiety in their voice, she just stops what she's doing and she looks at you and she's there for you. And I think that's very rare to find in people nowadays.
I am 100% certain that not many of us would have made it through last year if Davina hadn't been there. She maintained such a positivity in a time that was so strange.
What inspires me is being able to make a difference. I've read this book and they describe being a day maker as having like doing intentional acts of kindness with the intent of making the world a better place. And that's kind of my goal, just every day.
She's helped our school become successful because she really invests in our faculty and staff. She just wants to make sure that her team, her school team is happy, and then that goes into their classrooms and their teaching, and then the students receive that, and that's just what makes our school successful.
I've not met a person like Davina who is so good at the core. She wants the best for everybody else.
She doesn't believe that her job is only the school secretary. Her job is customer service. Her job is to make sure that everyone that comes onto our campus, whether it be the superintendent or a parent, feels welcomed, feels informed, feels that they know that they have a place at our school.
She has a huge heart. Like, if she finds out a student needs something or she's developed a relationship with them, she's available to talk to them, she'll give a kind word, she'll go check up on students to see how they're doing.
It's important that we make them feel welcome. There's a lot of baggage that these children are coming into school with. And you have to be empathetic and you have to open up your heart to know that a kind word will go a long way.
She treats everyone with the utmost respect that they deserve as a human being. And that is the tone that carries through the school because of her example.
I feel like I always say a student must be educated to be healthy and healthy to be educated.
She's just got more bandwidth up there than maybe I do or others that she works with. And if they have a need, she's there for them to help them.
Sometimes you had kids that were just coming up for a Band-Aid and she's asking how they're doing, how their sports are going, how their family life is going. She really connected with kids so they felt safe when they had to come to the clinic.
Students will walk in and they'll say, you know, I heard you're safe to talk to and I'm struggling with this. And so that's been really big for me.
As a staffing specialist, I have to know a lot about a variety of different kids. And she typically will know things that I wasn't aware of.
My impact is more on a student's success in their mental health, their physical health, their diagnosed medical condition.
She just digs deeper for just whatever it is she's doing, she just is a little bit deeper than most people.
It's just really cool to be able to be in the spotlight for a minute and say, this is what we do, and this is how we take care of these kids, and it's not just handing out Band-Aids, like there's so much more to it.
Office is literally the place to be. Our staff, our students, they love to try to go to see Ms. Perez at any point during the day that they can. The students especially, we have students who literally try to sneak into the front office to go see Ms. Perez.
Ms. Perez, when she interacts with the students at Wheatley, she tends to she stops everything she's doing, she gives them full attention. She gets to know the student for who they are and what their needs are, and that's how she's able to relate to the students.
It's funny because a lot of students, I've been there for so many years, they have kids, their kids come to our school, And now that they're grown, they come and say, I remember you, and I remember when you used to give me snacks, or I remember when you used to give me a hug, or, and so that's rewarding. So when they come to the school, they now have a familiar face. And so it has been like that throughout the years. A joke I have with my family is like, I cannot go anywhere without makeup or anything because everybody here in Apopka knows me.
She's just invaluable. She's such an asset to our team because she's just always, again, just so willing and so giving and so loving and just selfless. Everyone needs a Miss Perez.
Everybody needs to feel safe and heard and seen. And me pushing character development into my curriculum at my program significantly decreased physical altercations, bullying, and the kids, they became family. And when all of them went up to hug this child because he was very upset, I think that was the moment right there when I knew that there's something special here.
Students who maybe come from a different demographic or kids who just don't feel like they fit in, that's where Ms. Joy shines. She helps them to bridge gaps, and then the students have so many benefits because of it.
She fights for those students who don't have equity, whether it's ESE students or, you know, black and brown students. She wants to have a diverse school where everybody is included and treated the same.
We as educators have a job to do to make sure that they feel like they're not secondary. They are an equal.
She wants to give them each, you know, an opportunity to do their very best, and I think she brings that out in them.